Let me tell you about one of the first vulnerabilities I wrote about, CVE-2008-1930. It's an amazing vulnerability that impacted WordPress in 2008. Let's dive in. WordPress allowed users to create a Remember Me cookie that will last longer than the current PHP session. To do that, the WordPress developers had to write specific code. What they did was take the current username, add an expiration time, and sign the concatenation of both values using HMAC and a secret. Without the secret, you cannot generate a valid signature and those cannot be logged in. So only your WordPress site could generate a valid Remember Me cookie. The cookie was then created by concatenating the username, a pipe, the expiration, another pipe, and the HMAC value. When passing the Remember Me cookie, WordPress will split the cookie based on the pipe character to get three values: username, expiration, and HMAC. It will check the expiration to make sure the cookie hadn't expired. Then, it will concatenate the username and expiration and compute a signature which it would name hash. Finally, it will check that hash and HMAC are equal. Have you found the bug already? Feel free to pause the video and see if you can find it. Now, let's look at the attack. First, we create an account admin 1 and get a Remember Me cookie, which is our username, an expiration time, and the HMAC. Then, the magic happens. We move the 1 from admin 1 to the expiration part of the cookie. We then send a request with our tempered cookie. The application checks the expiration, which is now even bigger than the one we originally had. Then it concatenates the username and expiration and computes the hash. Since the hash is exactly the same, since admin plus 11353464343 and admin 1 plus 13534643443 are the exact same string. And just like that, we are logged in. To fix the issue, the developer added a pipe when computing the signature, making it impossible to move part of the username into the expiration. I love this type of bugs. They are all about breaking crypto without doing any complex math. But let's see what we can learn from it. Just because something is signed doesn't mean you can't tamper with the information. You should always have delimiters when concatenating values to compute a signature. You don't need to be a math wizard to break some crypto. And finally, look at the features developer had to implement as opposed to what they get for free from the language or framework. I hope you enjoyed this video and that you are convinced that you can learn a lot from old bugs. Remember, those that fail to learn from history are doomed to repeat it.